We like to figure ourselves right into the action. If it's here and you want it, woo! Come and get it, because we're in town for a party, Daddy.
You greased up musclehead punk! Then what are you gonna do? Lay on that couch and shrivel up? That's what'll happen! You'll be a Richard Simmons lookalike! You'll be a punk! Oh! That's what I do in the morning when I kick 5 girls out of bed! I go, woo! And they go, woo, woo, woo! Because they know they've been with the world champion. You're talking franchise, you're talking money, you're talking notoriety, you're talking women, kids stealing, wheeling, dealing, limousine riding, jet flying, son of a guns, that have kissed all the girls and made them cry. Woo! And I'm telling you, yes, I'm excited! John Tony, you got Ric Flair, the captain of the team behind you. Ooh. Learn to love it. Diamonds are forever.
Woo. Tell them like it is, girls. Put that camera on that sign one time. Woo. And I want the whole world to know I got my Learjet sitting right out there at Pete's Feeny Cab. And in just about 20 minutes, I'm on ease down the steps, Ted Turner by my side, getting my limousine, riding on 85, getting my Learjet, woo, and take off to New Orleans. You got it, New Orleans. If you're watching right now, I'm 42,000 feet, easing on in. Because in several hours, woo, I'm gonna walk that aisle looking as only the nature boy can look. Oh, so fine. I'm not even gonna tell you, it's gonna be JD on my left and Mary on my right, but I'm not telling any of you which one of my robes I'm wearing till I get there tonight. And in New Orleans tonight, the joint's gonna be packed. And I don't do no job in front of 70,000 people. I walk down that aisle and I take care of it. Who is only Slick Rick here? I'm going to ease across the street to the Hyatt Regency and drinks, all the champagne, anything you want is on the world check. And I don't mind telling you, I was wearing these $600 custom-made leather shoes. That's why I'm Ric Flair. Would you ride down the road with that golden retriever? You call a woman and talk to her? Huh? Would you go fishing? Would you sit in the corner bar with all the other rednecks drinking beer, talking about being the champ? Come on, pal. Dreams are meant to be exactly what they are. A dream reality. It's custom-made clothes, limousines, blonde hair, styling and profiling, Rolex watches, yes, and any woman just like that. Everybody needs to have something to live for each day. But you, in reality, are never, ever gonna be able to say you are the world champion. You're never gonna be able to put this in your old pickup truck next to your blue jeans and your cowboy boots and your cut-off t-shirt and try to tell anybody, much less yourself, that you're the world champion. You gotta be born a champion. You gotta have it inside. You gotta feel it, live it, breathe, and be prepared to die for it. You gotta make the assault on life itself. That's why some people think I've lost it. I haven't. What I've done is There's no woman in the world that likes to be called Fetzel. But Sweatzel, that's your name. So you sit there and keep your mouth shut. I don't care what kind of shape you're in. I'm going to knock your teeth back out the other side of your head. You understand that? You find a chair to sit in. You keep your mouth shut. And I got to be kind of calm here. I don't want anybody out here telling me I'm off the air. I'm going to be on the other side of that dressing room through the cement wall. Listen to the doctor pull the stitches through your body. That's a promise. You're way too pretty. You're an untouched commodity in our sport. That means you haven't bled and sweat and paid the price to be out here cracking on the world champion. When you are an established commodity, when you are a man of means, when you are the man that says he owns, operates, and dictates what this does, then, pal, you can walk out here and crack on anybody you want to. You're going to be mine. I've been champion for a long time, Tony, simply because I'm the best there is. I got more women waiting for me in that hallway, quivering, shaking, having conniptions, than you've met in the last 5 years. You know why? Because I just happen to be Slick Rick, the World Heavyweight Champion. You imitation, nothing happening, punk. You keep walking around that ring trying to tell the world you're me, you better go somewhere else for your clothes besides Kmart. I'm coming out west next week, and baby, you remember one thing. Wherever I go, they can't make up their mind whether they call me the greatest, Slick Rick, or just plain, oh man. Right, baby doll? Yeah.
You know, it's hard for me to take my eyes off that monitor sometimes when I see myself on this nationally televised wrestling program, because I know the gut reaction and the impact that I have on the national public. Boy, I'd like to be like Ric Flair. He's got it all. You know what I'm talking about, Tony?
Exactly.
I mean, you know what I'm talking about, right? I mean, I've got a financial empire. I've got the World Heavyweight Championship. They all want to be like the Nature Boy. But there can only be one. The franchise, Ric Flair, the greatest of them all. Well, Ric Flair has been the man as long as being the man was cool. Honey, don't try to wrap me up. These people out here turn on that program every day because they want to see the world champion.
I can say now, smart guy, all of the day's work.
You wouldn't let him come
into the world champion.
You wouldn't let him get in the ring.
Talk to your mother, not me.
Come on, Rick.
Now, we can talk about a lot of people in wrestling, but we're going to talk about one because he's the best, the most well-known, the best-looking, the best-dressed. As a matter of fact, when he was coming through the airport today, he heard all the Eastern Airlines stewards just standing in the corner, you know, gawking like this. They were saying, Rambo who? When Ric Flair walked by. Then, you know, Slick, as in Slick Rick, the world's heavyweight champion. You know, I deal with my opponents a little bit like I handle my love life. I make sure I leave a lasting impression. You understand what I'm telling you guys? I'm gonna get in the ring and show you once again, Tony. Why? Woo! Why? I'm the world champion, brother. Y'all out there, take a good look at what's going on. Not just another pretty face. Not just the best looking man alive. Not just the best dressed man, but the greatest athlete on the face of this earth, brother. And when you wake up in the morning, you do yourself a favor. You pattern your life after Ric Flair, and you'll be something. You'll be something in this world that someone can say they're proud of. Because Ric Flair is what's happening in the world of professional sports. Pass the word around, Daddy.
I've been teared up all day long with the thought of not being able to come out here anymore, but I'm off. I'm off. And I'm in a good place. And I love you.
the memories. Thank you for the support. And most of all, thank you all for making me who I am today.
Woo! If you think these people here in Orlando are the only ones that want to say thank you, if you think that the millions of people watching on TV are the only ones that want to say thank you, well then, my friend, you've got another thing coming. Because I had to come out here and I had to tell you something from the bottom of my heart. I love you, man. And thank you. Thank you.